My name is Jackie Ramos, and I would like to tell everyone a story. I am a former employee at Bank of America in Kennesaw, Georgia, at 210 Town Park Drive. I worked in the Customer Assistance Department from May 1st, 2009 until November 23rd, 2009. And by the way, customer assistance is a euphemism for the Collections Department. Every day I came to work and did just as I was supposed to. I collected. In fact, I was one of the top performers in my department, even outdoing those who were more tenured than I was. But something was wrong. There was something inherently evil about my job. I'm not sure if Bank of America knows this, but we are in a recession, and most of us, we are hurting. Day in and day out, I was told to charge people who already fell behind in their credit card bills an additional $15 just to make a payment with me. As I was told by Tiffany Gatlin, my manager, it was a convenience fee. I was told to deny refunding as many late and over the limit fees as I could. There was even one month I was given a verbal warning about the amount of fees that I refunded because, as I was told so many times, Bank of America is a corporation and they are for profit. There is something we have in my department called a fixed pay. Essentially, it is a program. It turns your balance into an installment loan, and it stops all fees on the account, and it also closes your account. In order to get a fixed pay, though, you have to qualify by answering a rather irrelevant set of questions, like how much you spend on groceries and how much your cell phone bill is. Day in and day out, I had to deny countless people countless people who needed the program but didn't qualify. Too often, I would have to give them the spiel about, I can't accept your program because your disposable income is too negative, and then they just sit there on the phone and say, well, if I could afford to pay my bill, why would I need a program? I will never forget one cardholder. I remember her name, her location, I remember her story. 24-year-old woman with a child, just found out she had cancer. She lost her mom and her husband all in the same year. Of course, she had a very limited income. She had to quit her job. But she still respected Bank of America enough to try to pay off her $6,000 debt. But she just needed help. She sobbed on the phone telling me she couldn't afford the 30% interest that we had her, 29.99% interest that we had her account at. She couldn't afford the $39 late fee, the $39 over the limit fee. She told me that we were her first credit card when she turned 18. We were her only credit card, and that she was a loyal customer, and given the time to be on this earth a little while longer, she would have always remained a loyal customer. I couldn't put her on a program. She didn't have enough income. According to Bank of America, she doesn't have enough income to be put on a program, but she does have enough, I'm sorry, but she can, however, keep paying the high interest rates on the account and fees, because at the end of the day, it is her account. She did rack up the debt, and she was late, so she did deserve that 29.99% interest rate that she had, and it wasn't up to Bank of America to help her figure out how to get this debt paid off. It was up to her. There's a joke in my department. Upstairs, they sell you the credit. Downstairs, we collect on it. Too often, I heard stories of how senior citizens and college students were specifically targeted so Bank of America could continue to make money off of them. I had one elderly lady who was legally blind. Every month, she sent them the incorrect amount because she couldn't see. Her 3% APR, after I think about three times of being late, went to 29.99%. She actually told me that one of the associates told her she needs to look at her statements more clearly. After all, who better to target than the young and the old? Don't deny for a second that there are systematic practices put in place to keep America in debt. Bill Rabel. I love this guy. I mean, he is genius. Any corporation that hires him, I mean, you've hired a good person. I'm not doing this video because I'm bitter. I'm not doing this video because I hate him. In fact, as my boss, I still have a lot, or as my old boss, I still have a lot of respect for him. Out of all the interviews I had in my life, I will never forget the one I had with him. He told me the most interesting interview question he's ever been asked is, what keeps you up at night? Before I got the job, that question didn't really make sense to me. who asked that in an interview, I thought. But now that I've been in that department for a while, it makes sense. It does seem normal. All the people that I've had to deny programs to, they kept me up at night. All the people that I've pissed off with the $15 convenience fee, they kept me up at night. All the people who were dying, lost a child, husband, mom, dad, all the people who lost their jobs and sat on the phone sobbing to me that if we just gave them a little bit of help, they can make their ends meet, they kept me up at night. All the angry cardholders who told me the reason why Bank of America is the corporation that it is off the hard work of them and their tax dollars, they kept me up at night. So I stopped denying people. I helped people get on programs that didn't necessarily qualify, but definitely needed the help. Every day I was told three things. Do the right thing for the customer, think of yourself as a customer, and do the right thing for the company. I figured if I placed more cardholders on programs at affordable rates, then maybe they can afford their light bill or even enjoy a trip with their child to the movies. If the account was affordable for the cardholder, it wouldn't charge off. I mean, that seems as simple as one and one being two. But my company didn't think so. At the end of the day, I would love to have a company who thought of me as more than just a dollar bill. I would love to have a company think or just be more humanitarian and think of me as a person instead of a profit. But the three things that I was told to think about every day, my interactions with cardholders, it didn't matter. In fact, only one of them did. Do what is right for the company. Again, Bank of America is for profit. They would rather charge 30% interest any day than give hardworking Americans, like me and you, a lower interest rate and work with us instead of against us. So, Bill Rabel fired me. He told me I can't people on programs who don't deserve it. During our meeting, he asked me if what I did was right. I looked him dead in the eye, and I said absolutely. I know he was expecting me to maybe say no or to apologize, but there's no apology. There's no way I could look myself in the mirror every day and justify not helping someone when I have the power to do it. Given the opportunity to do it again, I wouldn't change a thing. He actually looked at me. He told me he understood why I did what I did. He said that, you know, I had a really big heart, but at the end of the day, it was policy, and he had to let me go. He told me my manager would escort me to the security desk and that all my stuff would be there. And he was right. All my stuff was there in two boxes, all my awards, all the pictures of my son, even a plate of food that I had on my desk. Fabiola Clark packed all my belongings, including the plate of food, threw it in the box. All the food got all over all my shoes and awards, even the picture of my son. After all, Bank of America, they're just a corporation. They're not concerned with their employees' well-being or clearly even their cardholders. There's a saying in my department that you are as good as your last payment. No truer words could have been spoken. I'm not necessarily sad about losing my job. I felt like I took a stand and I did what was morally correct. I have a wonderful support system. I have a college degree and I consider myself personable. So I'm sure I'll land back on my feet. In fact, as my manager was escorting me outside, she told me if I needed a reference, she would highly recommend me to everybody. I received nothing but accolades while I was at Bank of America, and even while I was getting fired, my boss told me that out of anyone she's ever met, I've had the highest morals and the biggest heart she's ever seen. And that means more to me than my job. At the end of the day, I don't have anything keeping me up at night anymore. I did the right thing, and in God's eyes, I'm sure that he'll bless me. But Bill Rabel, can you say the same?